Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15.5 has been out almost a week at this point, along with 15.6 Beta 1 that's been out for a few days. So let's take a look at how it's going for most of us with battery, bugs, and more, and also a few things I didn't mention in the initial What's New video. Now the first thing I didn't mention because, well, it doesn't pertain to the United States, but rather communication safety has expanded to New Zealand, the UK, and Canada. And so as you can see here, we have child safety or child communication safety. Now this has to be enabled by the parent, so you need a family account, and then you can enable it within your communication safety settings under screen time. So this is something that they've added. This does not need to be turned on at all, but basically it will let your child know if it thinks there's an image that may not be appropriate, but then it also warns them and then asks them to contact a parent or if they want to see it for sure or not. Again, you can turn this off if you don't want it to be there. Also, the first time you open up iTunes, there's actually a new splash screen. I don't really use iTunes too much. I use TV and movies and things like that. So let's go to iTunes. I already went past it here. So if we go to the iTunes store, the first time you go into it, you'll get a new pop-up screen or splash screen. It just says, welcome to the iTunes store. Get the music you want, watch the latest movies, enjoy ad-free TV shows. So that's something that's new in 15.5 that I didn't mention in the initial What's New video. Now, as far as the overall experience, I did run a YouTube community poll, and at the time of this video, there's almost 10,000 votes and 213 comments. I've read all of those comments to get the best understanding of what 15.5 and 15.6 are like. With iOS 15.5, it seems there are three issues that seem to be a standout issue. So most people say it's quite good, and it's definitely worth installing, but there's three standout issues. Connectivity seems to be the number one standout issue. So typically on T-Mobile, it seems to be the most problematic. And the reason I say that is earlier this morning, they actually said there was a problem with connectivity on T-Mobile if you use an eSIM. So if you're using an eSIM and not a physical SIM card that goes into the side of your phone, there's a problem with connectivity where sometimes it could just deactivate altogether and then not reactivate. So this is a problem on T-Mobile, and maybe they can fix it remotely, or it could be fixed with maybe a 15.5.1. So we'll talk more about that in a minute. But other people are having issues with connectivity, switching between LTE and Wi-Fi and 5G and 4G. It just seems to be really slow overall, having more drops and disconnects. And the odd thing is in iOS 15.6 Beta 1, Apple reverted the modem back one version, and it seems to have resolved those issues. So all of the connectivity issues I was having, whether that be with speed overall, if we go down to speed test here, speed overall seems to be pretty good on 15.6, and I've been running both of them depending on the device here. So we'll wait for it to connect. I'm on 5G UC. Let's see what we get. So I'm getting about 50 megabits per second down, which isn't great, and this can change greatly. I only have 2 bars of service, and this can go to many hundreds, or sometimes it's just poor like it is right now. So it really depends on the day and where I'm at. I'm at 86 megabits per second down, about 8 megabits per second up, or 9 megabits. So not incredible, but it's working fine for me now on 15.6, but was definitely problematic on 15.5. So that may be a consideration. If you have T-Mobile, you may want to hold off. Also, I was having a lot of touch issues with 15.5. So maybe I'd go into music and then it just wouldn't work well, or I'd go into the app store. And sometimes just touching on different apps or just trying to get out of the app altogether would be slow or just not responsive. So going into the different apps, going back out, sometimes would take a second and I'd have to tap multiple times. Also, mail continues to be an issue. If I turn off Do Not Disturb here, you'll see the different notifiers. I have 36 unread email at this point, and mail seems to be a problem where it keeps showing the wrong indicator as far as what's unread. So I've been having those issues, and I actually asked on Twitter what email client you use because I was having issues and wondering if it was affecting battery as well. Even with 15.6, mail continues to have an issue. So there's definitely some odd things there. Now, as far as battery life, what I found by going through all of your comments is that with iOS 15.5, if you had good battery with 15.4.1, typically you're going to see good battery with 15.5. However, those of you that had issues prior to this with 15.4.1 or even 15.4 or older typically still have poor battery. That's what I was seeing as far as a pattern in all of your comments. Now, battery health on my device is still at 100%, which is quite good. So I just put this on the charger every night, put it on my car, which is a wireless charger, while I'm driving, and that's about it. I don't do anything special. I leave optimized battery charging turned on. And so I also took a look at coconut coconut battery to see what this had to say, and it's also saying it's at 100%. And you can see the cycle count here as well. So it's doing quite well that way. If we take a look at my battery usage, yesterday I had 2 hours and 31 minutes of screen on time, 7 hours and 41 minutes of screen off time. You'll see there's a bug here too with recently deleted apps where it's not showing anything. So I'm seeing a lot of background activity even though background app refresh is turned off on many of these apps. The day before that, you'll see I only had 3 hours and 48 minutes of screen on time, 6 hours and 25 minutes of screen off time, and used about 75% of my battery. I'm actually having okay battery life, but it's very hit or miss. Depending on which version we're running on, it seems to be about the same. So you'll see from Thursday forward that we have, well, Thursday forward, I'm on 15.6. Before that is 15.5, so about the same battery life. Typically, by the time I go to bed, I have about 40 to 50% of my battery life left. Others are having a phenomenal experience, though. It doesn't seem to bother me too much on the 13 Pro Max, but on the iPad, it still continues to be an issue. Now, the overall experience with iPadOS seems to be okay. I've still had some of those touch issues I mentioned with 15.5. 15.6 did seem to improve that, but battery life hasn't improved at all. So you can see coconut battery here. I'm not at 100% as far as battery health on the iPad and have quite a few cycles with it, but that's okay. I use it regularly. And you'll see yesterday I had 2 hours and 52 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 3 minutes of screen off time, and used about 60% of my battery. I'm only getting 5 to 6 hours of screen on time on the iPad, and it continues to be an issue. I'm hearing more and more from more people that they're having the same issue as well. So hopefully this is something that Apple can resolve, maybe with iPadOS 16. But overall, the experience is similar except for battery life. Now, the storage bug is something I wanted to mention, but I'm not sure that many of you want me to mention it regularly, as this seems to be very hit or miss depending on who you ask. Most people say that the storage bug is resolved, meaning when you go into iPhone storage, it loads fine. That's not the bug. The bug is the system data usage. So once this loads down at the very bottom, you'll see system data, and it will be much larger than you would expect. So if we go all the way to the bottom here, you'll see here system data is still loading. We'll give it a minute to load and then we'll take a look. You can see my system data finally loaded. I have 6.23 gigabytes in use. Just before this, it was above 8 gigabytes. This changes over and over time when you're looking at it. So different things can store data here. So different caches such as Safari can store data. And by clearing that, sometimes it will clear this up. However, I did see someone send in that they had over 80 gigabytes of use. So that's definitely an issue. And you really need a third-party app to clean that out, or maybe clear the cache in Safari and see if it helps. But there's definitely some issues for some, but for most it seems that system data is smaller. So we'll take a closer look at that maybe in a different video and see how we can fix that for many people. As far as the phone getting too hot, there are some people saying that it gets far too warm compared to what it did before, and that 15.4 was better for them, or 15.4.1. However, other people say that it's much better this time around. So it really seems to be very random this time with 15.5, who's experiencing bugs and who isn't. Now with iOS 15.6, it does seem to fix those touch responsiveness issues and the connectivity issues. Rolling back that modem definitely made a difference, and hopefully they can roll this out soon. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 15.5, I would say if you have an eSIM and you're on T-Mobile, I might hold off because we could see a new version to fix that. If Apple can't resolve that remotely, we could see that. So everything else, though, seems to be much better with 15.5 for the majority of people. However, with the issues you're having, I wouldn't expect any major fixes with it. But there were a ton of security updates in 15.5. So if we go to the Apple security website, you can see if we scroll down with iOS 15.5 and iPadOS 15.5, there are a ton of security updates. So I would recommend installing this unless you're on T-Mobile with an eSIM, just to take care of some of those security issues. However, we could see an iOS 15.5.1 as soon as this coming week if Apple can't resolve that T-Mobile issue. So if they can't push that fix out remotely to fix connectivity, I would say we could see that as soon as this week where they resolve that with a small update, with additional security fixes and maybe some bug fixes as well. So hopefully we'll see something like that, and then we'll be on to 15.6 betas with beta 2, and then of course iOS 16 on June 6th. So on June 6th, we're all waiting for that. We'll have WWDC 2022. We'll have the keynote with new features with iOS 16, which is expected to be pretty large at this point, along with watchOS 9, also expected to be a pretty major update. So I'm looking really forward to that. iOS 15 seems to be mostly complete. and slightly solid at this point. It's not 100%, but it's slightly solid. So depending on what device you're using and who you ask, many people say performance is better. But September is when we can expect iPhone 14, of course, with iOS 16, watchOS 9, tvOS 16, macOS 13, and so on. And maybe even a new VR AR headset with Reality OS. So I'm looking forward to all of those things. Now, if we take a look at the YouTube community poll at the time of this video, let's refresh it, we have 9,900 votes. So almost 10,000 votes and 213 comments. 49% of you are saying 15.5 is great. 34% of you are saying it's the same as 15.4.1, 7% say it's terrible, 9% are on 15.4.1 or older, and 2% are using 14.8 or older. So many of you haven't updated yet for whatever reason. Maybe you're on an older device and you're just happy with it. But for those security reasons, Apple is no longer updating previous versions, so I would recommend installing it just for that. But again, if you have an eSIM, I wouldn't do that yet if you're on T-Mobile. However, let's take a look at some of the comments and what you had to say. So like normal, I have my iPad below, and Floresto Villaflor said, I live in the Philippines using iPhone 12 Pro Max. I use Smart 5G. After iOS 15.5, switching from Wi-Fi to mobile 5G takes too long, or is too long to take effect. Long enough that I have to switch off my iPhone and still took a little while for my data to kick back in, unlike iOS 15.4, which is perfect. So there's definitely something up with this version of iOS 15 where we just have some odd bugs as far as that goes with switching between cellular and Wi-Fi. I'm not really sure what they did there, but there's definitely something going on. 50Fox says it's okay, however, I'm getting an issue where notification icons are disappearing. The little image to the left, that's the app icon slash profile picture of the contact. Restarted phone multiple times with no luck. And so there's definitely some odd issues, and they seem to be very random this time around, depending on who you ask. Chaitanya Ashtekar, hopefully I'm saying that properly, finally my iPhone XS heating and battery draining issue is resolved now. I'm happy with this update. No bugs noticed as such. Dennis Jones says, no problem on either the iPhone 7 Plus or the 12 Pro Max. The 7 Plus battery life is better. On the 12 Pro Max, it seems the same as 15.4.1. Artie Vortex says, using iPhone 11 Pro Max and battery life is still pretty bad on 15.5. Something happened on 15.4 that made battery life of my phone way worse, and it hasn't really improved with updates. Battery health is still at 93%, so that shouldn't be the issue either. And like I said before, this is where what I'm seeing over and over is, if you had poor battery life before, chances are it's not going to be resolved. However, if you had better battery life with 15.4.1, it seems that it's gotten even better or about the same with 15.5. Rodrigo said, having a lot of issues with this patch on my iPhone 12 Pro, specifically with the default mail client. When even I try to reply to any email, the app will just close on pressing of the send button. It's not even saving as a draft. So the mail app overall is just crashing. The only thing I could suggest with this is maybe uninstall the mail app and then reinstall it from the App Store. Sometimes that resolves the issue, and a lot of people have been seeing mail use a lot of background activity too. So again, something up with the mail app. Maybe Apple's getting ready for iOS 16 or going to change something. It's hard to say at this point. Hunter Price said, I'm using iOS 15.5 and my iPhone 12 Pro is pretty much good. It seems the battery life has improved versus iOS 15.4.1. Everything is smooth and there's no issues except with Siri not working sometimes. Mega Jeremy says, mine seems to have improved. I'm coming home to around 40 to 50% compared to 20 to 30%, doing all the same stuff. And so that seems to be the case for many people. Like I said, if you had good battery before, you'll have good or better battery this time around. If you didn't, there's still some issues. So be sure to check out what's using your battery in the battery settings, maybe under some apps that are causing it. Typically Facebook or Facebook-owned apps seem to have that issue a lot, it seems. And then of course, iOS 15.6 Beta 1 didn't show us a whole lot except for in the code, so I expect some of those features to be available in Beta 2 or Beta 3. So look for that in maybe a week or two. Of course, all of the big changes will be in iOS 16, so that's what I'm looking most forward to. I think it's going to be much bigger than many of us think. But let me know what you'd like to see in iOS 16 in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.